The reasons why I don't think we have enough girls in STEM is there are a lot of perceptions about what is hard and what is easy, and a lot of the subjects that students would take to be able to launch off into that kind of career, say some maths, some chem, some physics, students perceive that they're hard, so then they don't take them.
I think the biggest barrier is lack of knowledge and lack of information about it, and I suppose that the portrayal out there is that it's a male-dominated area, but it really isn't.
I thought science was going to be really complicated because in my primary school we didn't do a lot of it. Like, I didn't think our resources were very good, so when I moved into secondary school I thought it would be really hard.
Kids doing science themselves at school is essential for them to want to do science. If we're still teaching straight from a textbook, no wonder kids are disengaged. But if kids are in there designing their projects about what they wanted to find out, they just love it. And not just that, they learn more, they remember it more. This is what I'm passionate about, is giving kids a go.
EngGirls is a program created by Dr. Hudson that aims to provide girls with education on entrepreneurial skills and like stuff from the STEM field.
Girls come together for 1 hour a week and they work on a project that they've designed, and it's about problem solving, it's about their project is about engaging other kids in STEM ideas. In previous years they've had Candy Crush, where the students have created this real life Candy Crush experience where there were castles and the students designed catapults where they launched jelly beans through the different castles. This year the girls are actually doing a tower challenge. The students will have to build a tower out of newspaper which has to withstand cyclones.
Part of trying to engage young people and particularly girls in STEM is to give them an opportunity to understand what science and technology and maths and how they link together, giving them an understanding of that and showing them that it's fun.
I feel like I only started to veer into science last year when I had Dr. Hudson as a teacher, and she really like made science fun and enjoyable for me, while in the previous years I was kind of like half on it.
At senior level, I'm finding the students are actually going 14 points, 8 points higher than what their predicted score would be. It's absolutely true that the less I'm speaking from the front of the room, the students' results are better. In fact, one of my students last year, she actually went from getting a D in the year before in science to actually getting an A+. She's an exceptional student, but she just wasn't engaged. So as soon as she was able to engage with the subject, she knew that this is what she wanted to do, and it completely changed her perspective on what she wanted to do and where she wanted to go.
She's certainly encouraging them into fields that focus on science and technology, and about not being afraid to pursue those interest areas.
In the future, I'd like to be in the medical career or medical side, and definitely science comes into that.
I was trying to be a lawyer before I entered Aiken College, but it's pretty much completely changed now.
The WISE Changemaker program, being part of that, absolutely changed everything about the way I see my role. I see that I can now make a difference in what is happening in the world of STEM and girls' engagement. I know that I can change things. I was lucky enough to win the National BHP Billiton Science Teacher of the Year Award this year, and that was for the work that we're doing in our classrooms and with our students, and giving them opportunities to actually design their own experiments and be researchers.
It makes me feel really privileged because I know a lot of people like may not have a role model in their life or someone who influences them, but for me, I absolutely love Dr. Hudson because she's so good.
Having Dr. Hudson as a role model is so amazing because I always look up to her. She is helping me with my future, helping me choose some subjects for my future.
They are passionate about what they're going to do and how they're going to run it. One of the things I learned at WISE Changemakers was authorship is more important than ownership. So these girls design their programs, and then my role is just to facilitate that. So my dream would be that the girls would come back and they would be able to say, yeah, I did it. I actually went out there and it was bigger and it was better and it was more than I ever imagined. And what you began here was just the seed. of something that I didn't know could grow and be so amazing.